Hello. So this wasn't supposed to be my next video, but I love Halloween and pumpkins, and then this happened. And it all just got out of hand. Okay, so let's rewind. I love Lego and I had planned on building a Lego pumpkin for Halloween. But then my friends at Raspberry Pi told me they were releasing a new build hat that allowed you to play with Lego and build cool inventions, and they are two of my favorite things. And then they told me they had this robot face tutorial which not only looks cool but will react to a trick or a treat, and I thought that sounded like the perfect face for my Lego pumpkin. So with the pretense of creating some TikTok content, little plug to follow me on there, I set about building a Lego pumpkin with a robot face.
This is Jack. He's kind of worried a lot of the time, but he is awesome.
And this thing was cool, but it also gave me an idea. If this pumpkin can recognize spiders or sweets, could I train it to recognize people's faces so I could set off some delightful tricks for certain friends? Now, AI learning is not something I've ever done before, and to be honest, it scared the shit out of me. But I was told about this awesome platform called Teachable Machines that even kids could use, so I decided to give it a go.
I'm just outside with my laptop in the drizzle, teaching it to recognize the faces, because obviously I'm gonna be testing it outside. So I thought I would train the machine in the environment that I'm gonna be in.
And once the model is trained, you can check how well it works, which is one of my favourite parts. Alongside teaching it to recognise my friends, I also taught it to recognise me so that I could get the treats and they could get the tricks.
Ah! Right, okay, neutral. It recognised me!
Now, although the AI learning part of this project might be new to me, the kind of setting off messy tricks is not. I run a YouTube channel with my friend Sean where we bring to life kids' invention ideas. It often involves lots of mess and ridiculousness. So once I'd trained my AI and given my computer a gold star, I set about setting up some of the tricks. And then I was done. Now, this all got out of hand in a very short amount of time, and so I couldn't get the actual people to test out the tricks. Also, some of them live a long way away. So I handcrafted these beautiful masks of their faces. We've got Colin Furs, who is a maker and inventor on YouTube. We've got Fran Scott, who is a inventor and maker and pyrotechnician. We've got Sean Brown, who is the other half of Kids Invent Stuff. We've got Stephanie, who is a maker, programmer, Instagram queen. And I'll make sure that links to all these people are in the description below. So this is my table of glorious pumpkins, and I've got my beautiful masks ready. And each of the masks should, fingers crossed, activate a different pumpkin. The one at the front is for Sean. We've got one here, which is for Fran. This one here should be activated by Colin. And this beautiful raspberry pumpkin, or the pumpkin pie, is for a Stephanie. Now, a Stephanie gets this one because she's American, they love pumpkin pie, but also she is the raspberry pie queen and she has massively helped me with this project. So before it rains, we're gonna get on and cause some Halloween mayhem.
It's been a very long few days. I'm really hoping I've not messed up any code. Let's give this a go.
Got my little Sean mask.
when I was testing, I had to be quite close. Why is it not working? Oh, 5 seconds. I know why it's not working. Okay, I need to go change some code. I'll be back. Okay, so I've changed some of the code. Let's give it a go. Why are the real people not doing this? Why is it me? Oh no, if I take my, okay. Remember how code works. Me, it's me. It's me! Ah! That pump runs for a lot longer than I was expecting it to. That was Sean's. It's supposed to be slime. It's kind of watery and green. Sean has been dating a lot recently, so I thought it was appropriate. So yeah, it works. It stopped when it's on my face, which means I can get the sweets. So yeah, all good. Okay, so that was Sean's pumpkin. And if you... Down. Okay, I might leave the mask on the floor. You have to get very close to activate them. And some of the other pumpkins are a little bit more volatile, explosive, dangerous. So I think I'm gonna have to move Beautiful Jack, my activation pumpkin, a little bit further away from the table because I'd like to keep my eyebrows and my hair and my arms. So all the other things are being activated by e-matches, which means we have one shot, which is kind of good because if I wave the mask around, I can't activate it for a second time. If I do, it does nothing, but fingers crossed. An exploding pumpkin. I saw that on American TV and I asked Fran, obviously she's a pyrotechnician, I asked her about it. She gave me some really good tips, hence the reason I had to have Fran set it off. Oh my word, that went with way more of a bang than I expected. Like, that was very impressive. Just a bit of pumpkin in my fence, you know, just a bit of pumpkin. It's still steaming. So I have gone round and warned all of my neighbours, so hopefully they don't fall out with me. But if they do, I'm just gonna blame Raspberry Pi. Next, on to Collins. Fire, we have fire. I actually think this one would look really good at night, so I'm gonna make sure that I take some footage of this at night. It's time for the last pumpkin. This is our pumpkin pie, and it's gonna be set off by Stephanie. Now, I've moved everything down here, around the corner from where it's gonna happen, because I think this one could be the most volatile of them all. So I'm gonna set it off from down here. There is a slight delay on this one, but let's give it a go. So that's how Halloween got out of hand and how this, not this, became my next video. Now this baby here is the anti-swear box and there's a video about this coming very soon. So if you like this sort of thing, stick around, subscribe. But thanks for watching and happy Halloween!